This is Chronicle on WCVB Channel 5.
Small town.
You know everybody. Everybody knows you.
Big personality.
At a carnival kind of atmosphere.
The one and only.
Last remaining beachfront amusement park left in New England.
Old Orchard Beach, in the swing after all these years. On New England's tallest test, we take the plunge. Batter up.
These guys all have a dream, and the dream is to make it big.
Stinktown comes out smelling like a rose.
Most all the residential have water views.
The main streets and back roads of the Maine coast. Next on Chronicle. 7 miles of sandy beach. 7 miles of pristine Atlantic waters. Old Orchard Beach, Maine, lies about 100 miles north of Boston. The spot was first promoted as a tourist destination in 1631. By the early 1800s, Old Orchard Beach was well known to vacationers. Summer crowds really mushroomed when the train service between Boston and Portland opened in 1842. Huge hotels have come and gone, many lost to fire. But longtime fans of this place along the Saco Bay have never stopped coming.
Old Orchard Beach is widely regarded as the most popular beach in all of Maine, and that's saying something. Every summer, people flock here to enjoy the Atlantic Ocean, as well as the historic Old Orchard Beach Pier.
They love to come here. It's got a carnival kind of atmosphere.
Richie Redmond is the longtime co-owner of the pier.
So it reminds them of going to the country fair back at their homes. We've kind of have a lot of things for everybody. We have shops, cotton candy, we have hot dogs.
We're serving the best hot dogs on the beach.
Built in 1898, the original pier was 3 times longer than it is today. In the 40s and 50s, the enormous casino ballroom attracted acts like Duke Ellington and Benny Goodman. But the casino was torn down in 1970. For several decades, the pier, and in fact all of Old Orchard Beach, had the reputation of being a seedy destination. But Redmond says that image has changed.
Old Orchard Beach itself has become a family-orientated kind of beach community that's still affordable. There's a lot more strollers with babies in them than there was the party crowd that was 20 years ago.
There's been a transformation of Old Orchard since 2005, and it's continually evolving.
Pat Brown is a big-time supporter of all things Old Orchard Beach. She's a relative newcomer here, having discovered the place while on vacation with her husband.
I love the liveliness. And then the thing I really enjoy is how small town it is. You walk around town, you know everybody, everybody knows you, you're always greeted. It's wonderful.
Brown admits she fell in love with Old Orchard Beach because it brought back memories of Revere, Massachusetts.
I just got the chills because there's very many things about Old Orchard Beach that reminds me of my childhood and the things I loved about Revere Beach.
Brown was thrilled to find the other big attraction at the beach, Palace Playland, is owned by another Revere native, Joel Golder.
I used to work down at Revere Beach. I worked at Nantasket Beach at Paragon Park. I worked at Lincoln Park in North Dartmouth, Mass. I was in Salisbury Beach.
Golder moved to Old Orchard in the 1980s and bought Palace Playland in the 90s, an amusement park that opened in 1902. Meanwhile, all of the parks he worked at as a kid have closed.
We're the last remaining beachfront amusement park left in New England.
Palace Playland offers rides for all ages, including the ever-popular Pirate, which looks gentle, but isn't. Joel Golder says he loves to hear his customers scream.
You can tell screams of joy as opposed to the other kind of scream, so we're happy to hear screams of joy. I love it. I enjoy people having a good time, seeing families. It's all about the family.
Old Orchard Beach may never be known as a haven of nutritional dining, not with places like Bill's Pizza, a huge local favorite, and the deep-fried institution known as Pier Fries, which has been serving just one item for more than a century. Town manager Larry Mead is a frequent customer.
They're the original Pier Fries. They are the crispiest and the saltiest, and you put a splash of vinegar on them. That's the way to go. They're awesome.
But if you really want to blow a diet, the place to do that is Dickinson's Candy. The store is the ever-expanding dream of owner Mike Dickinson.
I happened to apply for the candy shop when I was 14 years old. This was my first job, and here I am, never left. 34 years in the business.
Dickinson's Candy has taken on the personality of its surroundings. It is a show, a little bit Willy Wonka, and a little bit Walt Disney.
I like the wow factor. I like to make people smile. I enjoy what I do, every little bit of it. People are on vacation, they're wearing shorts, they're at the beach, they're in a candy store. It does not get any better than that combination.
Dickinson started small, but over the years has taken over 5 neighboring storefronts. The most popular item here, of course, saltwater taffy. This store, and in fact all of Old Orchard Beach, is a favorite with Canadians, like Stéphane and Michelle Deverin. They've come the 5 hours from Quebec City with 10 members of their family for their annual holiday.
Many people from Old Orchard Beach are very kind, so we keep coming back because we like it very much here.
Pour les enfants, c'est très bien parce que les enfants ont beaucoup de choses à faire, la plage, le magasinage, l'arcade, les jeux, donc les manèges, tout le monde y trouve son compte, quoi.
You'd say that again. This Saturday, Palace Playland opens a new 70-foot-high roller coaster called the Sea Viper. It can hold 210 people and goes at a top speed of 40 miles an hour. And then in July, it debuts a spinning coaster with the name of Wipeout. That one is imported from Europe. Well, in Biddeford, the weather takes a turn.
We're right in the middle of a thunderstorm, so hopefully we'll stay dry.